Hi guys, Harry here. Welcome to Scrap Science. Right, last video we said we had the plan to extract lithium from lithium ion batteries, and in preparation for doing that, the method that we've selected to use requires some nitric acid. And I thought the idea of making nitric acid was interesting enough as its own video. So here we are, we're going to dedicate this entire video to making our nitric acid for our project later on. Now, the standard method for generating nitric acid in the lab is to react a nitrate salt with a strong non-volatile acid. So the best choices are, of course, potassium nitrate and sulfuric acid. And then, of course, upon reacting the two together, you can distill off the nitric acid very easily because it has a relatively low boiling point. Sulfuric acid is relatively difficult for me to get hold of, and I don't really want to be wasting it on a process like this where we'd be using quite a significant portion of it. Luckily, there is another method which will generate nitric acid, and it's a lot easier for me to do, or at least it's cheaper, and that is to react our potassium nitrate with sodium bisulfate. Sodium bisulfate is a relatively strong acid that is much, much cheaper, for me at least. I can just buy this easily from the hardware store. So as you can see, what I've got here is all I've done, mixed around 35 grams of potassium nitrate with 1.5 molar equivalents of sodium bisulfate. That's quite an excess. Having an excess of sodium bisulfate for the reaction ends up giving us a better yield, apparently. So that's what we're going with today. Anyway, the idea is to just heat this up with our heating mantle. The mixture will melt because the sodium bisulfate is of the hydrated form, and then heating it up past the boiling point of nitric acid will cause the nitric acid to distill off. And you can see we have this distillation apparatus set up already. So without further ado, we'll get this started and then I'll talk you through the setup. So basically all we have is your simple distillation apparatus. We have the boiling flask over here with our heating mantle, and then all we'll do is we'll be condensing the nitric acid that we boil off and collecting it in this round bottom flask over here. We have a bucket of water and a pump in order to push cold water through our condenser. And see if we turn that on, and once that's going, you can see water flows through our condenser and out the other end. Anyway, we will turn that off for now, but the last part of our apparatus is based on the fact that the reaction that we are running is going to generate quite a large amount of nitrogen dioxide gas, and that's really quite impolite if you're just going to vent that to the atmosphere, in my opinion. Basically what we have is, as the gas is allowed to escape from our apparatus, it will be led through this tubing. This tubing definitely won't survive the nitrogen dioxide gas flowing through it, but I'm hoping that it will stay sealed for long enough to actually do our distillation. That will be led into this water over here, which will dissolve or absorb all of our nitrogen dioxide and form even more nitric acid. So ultimately it will improve our yield overall. Based on the fact that nitrogen dioxide is extremely soluble in water as well, we are leading it into the water through an inverted funnel, because leading it directly in with just a piece of tubing tends to give us suck back. So the nitrogen dioxide dissolves in the water so fast that it actually pulls the water back and into our receiving flask, which we definitely don't want to happen. So hopefully if we start getting sucked back, the volume of the funnel will prevent the water from actually being able to be dragged all the way back into our receiving flask. That's the idea anyway. And with that, you can see already we are starting to produce what I believe to be nitric acid. You can see it starting to flow through our apparatus now. Yeah, look at it go. You can also see, if we have a look through it, or maybe you can't see, there's a slight yellow color in the flask indicating the presence of nitric acid and nitrogen dioxide. So that's very promising. Thank you. Now that the distillation is well and truly away, a couple of other things that I forgot to note initially. You can see I have wrapped the distillation head in a whole bunch of aluminium foil. That's just to insulate it a bit, because with the molten salt method that we're using right now, with our potassium nitrate and sodium bisulfate salts mixed together, we can't really crank the heat up, because we just get so much bubbling of the two salts together that if we heat it up too hot, it'll just all bubble through our entire apparatus and ruin our product. So that's generally not a good idea. We have to run it on a very low heat and just very slowly distill our nitric acid across. So insulating the head here just makes it a little bit more efficient at these low temperatures to actually get our nitric acid to go through. You can also see the large amount of nitrogen dioxide gas that we've got going through, which doesn't seem too bad at this stage, but it is getting worse as we continue to heat the mixture. Another thing you've probably noticed by now, seeing as we have actually now generated a bunch of nitric acid, and this isn't just azeotropic nitric acid, this is red fuming nitric acid, so that's pretty close to 100% nitric acid. The nitrile gloves that you generally wear pretty much offer no protection against nitric acid. They will burn straight through the gloves. So what I've got on, usually, I mean, I took it off my left hand just to show you the nitrile glove, but what I'm wearing mostly for the distillation, now that it's actually going and we have some red fuming nitric acid in the flask, are these big thick gloves. They won't really offer any protection from nitric acid, but they're thick enough that I can take them off before any of the acid gets through them. And then finally, our nitrogen dioxide trap does seem to be working, because if we now check the pH, I have a little sample, a little drop of our suckback trap here. You can see it is slowly turning acidic. That's barely acidic right now, but that's a pH of 5 or something. So we're getting somewhere at least, absorbing some of the nitrogen dioxide. And as we make more nitrogen dioxide, I expect a lot more to be absorbed. Oh yeah, and final note is the fact that all of the joints in our apparatus are connected with Teflon tape rather than just regular joint grease for our glassware, because obviously nitric acid is going to destroy any kind of grease that we put on our joints. But with that, it looks like there haven't been any drips of nitric acid coming through for a while. It's really slowed down at this point, and we cranked the heat up quite hot. We're up to past 100 degrees Celsius now, so I think we have got all the nitric acid out of this run that we can. So I'll turn this off, I'll let this cool down, I'll go and have lunch while we do that, and then we'll have a look at our final yield. And you can see how effective our suckback trap is, because you can see the funnel itself has absorbed or pulled in all of the water from our beaker. And now that all of the nitrogen dioxide in our line is dissolving in the water, it's sucking the water back to the point where it's just sucking air from the atmosphere in, which is a good sign that we've got it working. And after all that, that is our yield of nitric acid. Maybe 30 milliliters if we're lucky. So after we finish this run, I think what I'm going to do is do 2 or 3 more runs until we have enough for what I need it for. And there we have it. That is our last distillation of nitric acid that we're going to do. I ended up doing 6 in total. So that's 6 rounds of 30, 35 grams of potassium nitrate. And in total, we used up 200 grams or so of potassium nitrate total. And in the end, you can see we have quite a reasonable yield of nitric acid. Hopefully that is enough to do our lithium extraction, and hopefully we'll have some left over so that I won't need to do this again for a very long time. I'm also extremely impressed that our tubing actually held up to the nitrogen dioxide flowing through it that whole time. There was a very long time that I was running these distillations, so that is very impressive that that held together for the whole time. And there we are, finally, that's it. Our yield of nitric acid, maybe 120 milliliters there. This is our waste, so this contains basically all of the salt mass that was left in our distillation boiling flask. All this contains is maybe some residual nitrate, potassium ions, sodium ions, sulfate ions, bisulfate ions. So nothing toxic here. We should be able to dispose of that relatively easily once it's neutralized. And then here we have our suck back trap that contains all of the nitrogen dioxide that didn't get captured in our nitric acid yield. As you can see, I've tested the pH again. That is very acidic now that we have spent a very long time pumping nitrogen dioxide through it. So that's good. We can use that as dilute nitric acid. We can use this as our red fuming nitric acid, which we can dilute if we want to use a lower concentration. But all in all, we're finally done. I would give you a demonstration of how red fuming nitric acid is capable of setting nitrile gloves on fire. But as it turns out, I don't think this acid is quite concentrated enough for that. I think quite a significant portion of water distilled over with our nitric acid. So it's not 100% nitric acid in the end, but it should be concentrated enough for any of our purposes in the future. So with that, I'll see you later.